Okay, let's discuss a good way to protect your third-gen Cummins from a common problem. A stuck piston. We had a mechanic call the other day, and he told us that he had checked a third-gen stock manifold at idle with a heat gun, and it was 100 degrees hotter on the rear three cylinders than it was on the front three cylinders. This mechanic's test falls right in line with our findings as well. When we ran pyros in each cylinder of a stock third-gen manifold, the temperature of the engine at the time was 1300 to 1500 degrees, we found that the rear three cylinders were on average 200 degrees hotter than the front three cylinders. 200 degrees is a big, big discrepancy. You see, EGTs in a third-gen Cummins can easily become a big problem. The third-gen Cummins has a very tight tolerance in the diameter between the piston and the cylinder wall, which makes the third-gen susceptible to sticking a piston when the cylinders experience extreme heat. And unfortunately, the poor airflow design of the third-gen stock manifold exacerbates this and puts the engine at a severe risk of blowing or having a stuck piston. See how port 4 and 5 blow right into each other? Look at that. Right into each other. This is one of the reasons why the factory manifold runs 200 degrees hotter on the rear ports than it does on the front three ports. This poor design on the stock third-gen manifold, it really creates excessively dangerous heat in these rear cylinders. That extreme heat causes the aluminum pistons to expand faster than the cylinder wall, and at a certain temperature, the piston will actually expand to a point where it touches the cylinder wall, which results in galding. Basically, the aluminum of the piston welds itself to the cylinder wall. This results in a stuck piston, thus destroying the engine and only fixable at that point with an expensive rebuild. So what can you do to protect your truck from getting a stuck piston? Our aftermarket DPS third-gen manifold, it's designed to divide the rear three from the front three ports and is engineered to flow better on the rear three cylinders, all of which allows the exhaust to escape easier, keeps the cylinders cooler. When we test our aftermarket performance DPS third-gen manifold on a computer model fluid dynamic testing, also known as CFD testing, it shows that our DPS third-gen manifold brings the temperature of the front three ports and the rear three ports within 2 degrees of each other. With this testing, we can trace air molecules throughout the system. We can see hot spots, turbulent spots, overflow spots, velocity, basically everything. This testing has given us the ability to design our third-gen manifolds to allow superior airflow. In fact, this CFD testing shows that our aftermarket third-gen manifolds flow within 1% as much air as our aftermarket DPS performance second-gen manifolds. Our manifolds bring the front and the rear nearly even in temperature, which means that our manifold runs 200 degrees cooler on the rear three cylinders than that of the factory manifold. Thus, our aftermarket third-gen manifold significantly reduces the chance of melding or sticking a piston in your rear three cylinders. The two-piece design allows for expansion and contraction, which prevents cracking, warping, and shrinking. These DPS third-gen manifolds are awesome in so many ways because they will reduce temperature, decrease back pressure, and improve spool-up. So, now you know you can protect your third-gen Cummins with a high-flowing DPS performance manifold.